While it's not a brand new product, Crafters Workshop Tacky Wind Dry Gel Medium is new here at Joggles. This is my first chance to experiment and play with it, and in today's video you'll see different ways it can be used. I'll bring out stencils, use it freeform, on chipboard, and with a couple of different kinds of shiny stuff. We're putting it in the Finnebert Fine Metallic Flakes on introductory sale at 20% off, and we'll apply that same discount to the existing iCraft Deco and Gina K foils. Links to all of the products can be found down below in the description. In addition to the Tacky One Dry Medium, I'm also working with iCraft Deco Foil and Gina K Foils, plus Finnebert's new Art Alchemy Fine Metallic Flakes. Foils and flakes are going to give you a little bit of a different look, but they both work equally well with the medium. You can use glitter, flocking, microbeads, anything that needs something sticky to adhere it or to hold it in place. So here are some examples of the foils. iCraft Deco Foil sold in tubes like this. I want to say there's 5 sheets inside that are 6x12. The Gina K foils are sold in a flat pack like this. And then Finnebert's Fine Metallic Flakes come in these big jars and they're pretty much full. There are a total of 6 colors. So when you look at these, and I'm actually going to take some that are out of the package, you can see that when we start talking about specialty designs, sometimes it's the color, sometimes it's the pattern, sometimes it's both. So this one is stars, but you can see that they're holographic depending on the way that the light moves. This blue has, what do I see in it? There are stars in this too that you can see. I've used some of it. Again, it's got a little bit of holographic feel. This is sequins, this is pink stars. This one is really interesting because it's gold, but you can see all of the reflection of the other colors on there because of that holographic effect. You have some that are rainbow, that the colors travel in one direction. These are particularly effective when you use them on a big piece. Things like this shattered holographic. And then solids, most of them are shiny, but you will find some in the Deco Foil line that are matte. There are a few and they're marked as matte. But again, there's a whole range of colors available here. So Tacky Wind Dry Medium has kind of an interesting property, and I'm actually going to slide this stuff out of the way. One of the things that I discovered, as I was playing, is that if you let this stuff sit for a period of time, and in general, this is pretty much ready to go. So I have this one, I'm going to bring it in a minute. You can see that most of this has transformed from white, which is what this stuff is, to it's gone glossy and clear. But when you let this, and this has been sitting about 15 minutes, when you let this sit longer, and I worked on this yesterday, and I'm going to come back to this. This stuff has kind of an interesting property where it stays tacky forever, but it loses some of that initial super sticky, is the only way that I can describe it, and it allows you to do some interesting things like use 2 different colors of foils like I did here. With that said, using this stuff is pretty darn easy. This is one of Elizabeth St. Hilaire's stencils. It's called, Peacock something or other. Peacock, it's in my notes here if I could only read it. Well, anyway, I'm going to use this stencil, and I've got, well, I should have, except that I didn't. Let me grab a 5x7 black index card, which is the mate to what I showed you a second ago. Now, I'm not going to cover this whole piece because you don't need to see me do that, but in effect, what you're going to do, now I'm going to tape this down with some painter's tape just because it makes it a little bit easier. You're going to use this like you have pretty much any other gel medium or gesso or those two kinds of things. Actually, I just saw my notes. This is called Feather Repeat. You're just going to scrape it on through the openings of the stencil. Now I'm going to show you some samples at the end of this segment, and you'll see that you don't have to use stencils. You can in fact do this freeform if you want. So I'm pretty satisfied with this. It doesn't have to be perfect coverage. It's close enough in my book. I'm going to scrape the rest off. Now the thing to know is that when this stuff dries, it dries tacky, and it will stay tacky. It's never going to dry to dry. That's the whole point of this. So I'm going to take this off and I'm going to put this stencil, I've got a tub of water to one side because I obviously don't want this stuff to dry on there. So give me 1 second. All right, so it's in water. Let's put that to one side because I'm not going to need that. And then I'm going to clean this up. So let me bring this in and I'm going to use, this is, oh good grief, what is this named? This is named Rainbow Shattered Glass. So I'm going to cover the whole thing with this, but I'm going to get a very different effect because the colors are going to travel. Now, initially, it's stuck, but you do have to rub this a little bit to get it to adhere. So I'm going to come in and I'm going to rub with my fingers. Now this is a 5x7 index card and there's a lot of medium on here, so I'm going to have to take a second and go ahead and rub until I'm satisfied that I've got all this covered, and then I might find that I have to come back. So I'm going to just start lifting. Holy moly, that's pretty. All right, so because this is very recently on here, as I said, the longer it sits, it gets to this a little bit less tacky stage that you can actually use to your advantage. But because this is very fresh, most of this is just going to go ahead and adhere. I'm not going to have to work too hard at it. So I could come back and I could be a little bit fussier about this than I was, but I'm not going to. But look how pretty that is. You get the color change along there. You get all that wonderful shine. And you see the pattern that's in there, especially up here. You can see that shattered pattern that is in here. So let me bring in this that I showed you a moment ago, and then I'm going to bring in some samples. So this is one that I actually worked on yesterday. But if you look closely, you can see that there are, hear it? It's still sticky. There are some areas where I haven't foiled in its entirety. So I've got black and I'm going to put it on here and I'm going to press pretty hard with my thumb because this has gone beyond that normal super tacky state. Holy moly, that looks really cool. And it now requires a little bit more effort to get that to go ahead and adhere. So I'm not going to go any further than that because I like the pink and the blue here and the majority of this is already done. But you can see, because this loses a little bit of its tacky state as it sits, then you can come back, foil it. I foiled this first with the turquoise, then I came back with the pink, and now here I am a day later and I'm coming back with the black. So this is just one of those things that you can, once you figure it out, and how this works in your climate is going to vary based on humidity and temperature and all of those things. But you'll be able to play with this and figure out how you can take advantage of that. So let me bring in a few things that I've already played with. This is a piece of our chipboard, and you can see that I put a couple of different colors on it. Not full coverage. I don't need full coverage because that can be a little bit boring. This is an example of all I did. You can see the foil on here. See the reflection? I scraped it on very randomly. Same thing here. This was a piece, and I don't remember which of them it was, but this was a piece that had multicolors on it, and you can see the color change along here. Same thing with this. Now, I put this, the Tacky Wind Dry Medium, on this very lightly, which is why there's not a lot going on here, because sometimes I don't want solid coverage. I want this kind of grungy, a little bit more worn look. Here's a tag. I used our, it's called Punchinella Quintet. It has 5 different designs and they're all little minis. You can see I did the stars here. This was super simple. I scraped, so this is one of our craft tags that I scrunched up and let dry, and you might remember that from the craft tag video. All I did, I'm not going to actually do it, but all I did was I scraped some of the medium out onto my surface, because this is nonstick craft sheet, I know it's, I'm going to be able to clean it up. And then I took this and I went and kind of scrunched it around, and you can see that the Tacky Wind Dry Medium is really only on the high spots, and then once it dried I was able to foil it, and I have this really cool effect because the foil is only up on the raised surfaces. This is that Gina K, it's the pink stars, or holographic stars, I think it's called Twinkling Pink. You can see the stars in there, you can see that holographic effect. And this is, I did this with Karen Tamar's, I think it's her medallion stencil. This is the holographic one that's named Glass Slipper, made by iCraft Deco Foil. And if I hold this up to the light, you can see the color change from turquoise to green. That's the holographic effect kind of in action. So being able to work with this and figure out how long you let it dry, how much longer you let it dry, and what you can do with it when you do those things makes for a really interesting product and lots of ways to experiment it. Up next, I'm going to bring in the fine metallic flakes and use them with the Tacky Wind Dry Medium. There are 6 colorways in the Finnebear Fine Metallic Flakes line, and each is actually a blend of several colors of flakes. The only difference between using them with the Tacky Wind Dry Medium and the foils is the application method, and let me show you how easy that is. So this is New York, this is Paris, this is Dublin, Moscow, and Barcelona, and I'm actually going to use Venice. Tacky Wind Dry Medium, I used our Bubble Blast stencil. I had to think about that for 1 second. So when you open this jar, you can see that it's filled up with stuff. Now I've used a little bit of this. So this is the Tacky One Dry Medium with our Bubble Blast stencil. It's been sitting a little bit. I have found that fine stencil designs don't work really well with this. I think that it's better if you use something that is more spread out, like you see this. So I'm just going to make a bit of a mess here and just go ahead and rub this on. Let's bring in a brush. Sometimes this helps. Let's bring that in. So what I'm trying to do is scrub the flakes out from around the area where the Tacky One Dry Medium is, because obviously right now they're kind of all running together. So it's just going to take a second, and I don't actually have flakes everywhere either, but you know what, if I turn this over, I bet I can pick them up this way. It's probably a little bit easier. All right, so I must have gotten medium. I must have been a little bit sloppy with how I applied the medium, but you can see that the design is starting to emerge as I brush the flakes kind of out of the way. Now, the one thing that I will tell you is that I did not, see right here, it wants to lift up. You just got to go in and monkey with it a little bit to get it kind of out of those places where it doesn't belong, because the flakes want to stick. And by stick, I mean the static electricity kind of stick. But you can see the design emerging here. And that's it. I mean, there's a mess here that I have to clean up, but that's really how simple it is. So one of the benefits of having all this stuff out on my workbench, and let's see what I've got going here. One of the benefits of having this stuff all out on my workbench, so let's get rid of this and let's just kind of slide this across and let's see if there's anything left on here that there might be a little bit. So I'm going to grab one of the foils and something that's a contrasting color. I'm probably going to come back to this black, because what I discovered is when you don't get coverage everywhere, or if you want to leave some of this uncovered, you can come back with the foil and you can add it. So that's the joy of having all this stuff out, is that I realized that I can actually combine the foil. Let's see where we are here. I can combine the foil with the flakes for an entirely different look. So, you know, cleanup is not fun. Sometimes it's absolutely necessary. But when you don't clean up is when you discover some of these places where it's not sticking is just because there's none of the Tacky One Dry Medium there. I simply didn't apply it completely through the stencil. But one of the benefits of having all this stuff out is the realization that you can combine these. Someplace here, I have a sample that I did this on, and I'll be darned if I can figure out where it is. So here it is. So this is the Tacky One Dry Medium, and I just kind of applied it randomly on this piece of craft index card. And you can see that I've got, which of these colors did I use? It was Moscow. So I used Moscow on here, and then I came back, and this is actually one of the deco foils. It's just the turquoise color. It's not an effect or anything. So you can mix this stuff up. Being mad scientist or playing mad scientist is a lot of fun. Sometimes experiments work, sometimes they don't, but it's only when you try that you discover kind of all these fun and interesting things that you can do. So that's my justification for when I don't clean up, is because it promotes all of this kind of weird synchronicity that otherwise I wouldn't think of. That's my story, and I'm sticking with it. So there are other types of media, as I said, that you can use with the Tacky One Dry Medium. I think glitter would be perfect with this. Flocking, and like I said, anything else that's loose that needs to be adhered, or something like a foil that's meant to be transferred.